Good morning, everyone. Welcome to my presentation. First of all, let me thank you all for coming here today. Myself, Bhagwan Aditya, studying BSc Honors Agriculture from Sheri Kashmiri University of Agriculture Science and Technology. I have prepared a presentation on production technology of rubber plantation crop. So before initiating my presentation, I am glad and thankful to Dr. Parshan Bakshi sir for giving me golden opportunity and valuable suggestions and encouragement in critical situations. Context of my presentation are general description of Sevier brasiliensis, economic importance, classification and nomenclature, varieties of rubber, agronomic practices, soil, sowing season, land preparation and planting, manure and fertilizer requirement, climate requirement, intercultural and weed control, pests and diseases, harvest and post-harvest practices, seed production, yield of rubber. Introduction. Hevea brasiliensis, commonly known as rubber tree, belongs to family Euphorbiaceae. It is quick-growing erect tree with straight trunk and an open leafy crown. The bark is usually grey and fairly smooth. The bark of the trunk is the part from where rubber is harvested. Taxonomic position. Kingdom Plantae. Division Magnoliaphyta. Class Magnoliopsida. Order Euphorbialis. Family Euphorbiaceae. Subfamily Crotonidae. Tribe Micranidae. Subtribe Heviniae. Genus Heviae. Species brasiliensis. Economic importance. Hevea brasiliensis is the major source of commercial natural rubber. Natural rubber is produced in the milky cytoplasm of the specialized cells called latticiferous. Is one of the most important macromolecule. It is used as industrial raw material for the manufacture of about 50,000 products. Hevea brasiliensis remains the only cultivated species as commercial source of natural rubber because of its abundance in latex and high quality and convenience of harvesting. Varieties of rubber. Robusta. One of the most common rubber trees, Robusta is easily identifiable by its bright green color and broad leaves. Robusta refers to plants more robust and hardy nature over earlier varieties. These varieties will grow tall. If you let it so, make sure you occasionally trim it to maintain the height you desire. Decora. Another green leafy variety, Decora has very dark green glossy leaves that are sometimes described as leathery. The leaves are slightly narrower than that of Robusta, although some sources claim this is a more compact version. I have seen plenty of instances where Decora plants reach over 6 feet in height. Burgundy. As the name suggests, this variety is known for its dark reddish green leaves. Burgundy is also touted for handling colder temperature better than other varieties, but I would still suggest keeping the plant above 50 degree feet at all times. This variety may also be known as Black Prince. Variegata. This common variegated variety of rubber tree has a classic green and yellow mosaic appearance with slight red central leaf veil. Although no slouch in the growth department, this variety seems less vigorous than the green leafed varieties above. In agronomic practices, soil. Rubber trees grow on a wide range of soils. However, deep 1 meter well drained soil free from underlying sheet rocks are best suited. In sowing season, the planting material for commercial cultivation is bud grafted plants raised in polybags. The field planting of bud grafted plants is done during May to August when sufficient rainfall is available. In land preparation and planting, the land is cleared of all vegetation followed by a light burn which retards regeneration of weeds. Rubber can be planted by adopting square of 4.6 into 4.6 meters or rectangular 6.7 into 3.4 meter planting systems. Square planting is suitable for level lands and rectangular system can be adopted in slopes. Proper drainage is facilitated by clearing natural waterways available or drains dug at an interval of 100 to 200 meter depending on the slope and drainage problem. Slit pits of about 120 cm length, 45 cm width, 60 cm depth are taken along the counter 150 to 250 per hectare to check erosion and to conserve water and soil. Construction of stone bunds is another method to check erosion in steep slopes. Rubber is planted in pits of 75 into 75 into 75 cm, refilled with topsoils. The normal planting density is 420 to 500 plants per hectare. Polybag plants with fully matured top whorl of leaves are used for field planting. Manure and fertilizer applications. Months after planting, dose of mixture per plant ratio. Now, NPK Mg to NPK. After 3 months of planting, to 225, 190. After 9 months of planting, for 450 to 380. After 15 months of planting to 450 to 380. 21 months of planting to 550 to 480. 27 months of planting to 550 to 480. 33 months of planting to 450 to 380. 37 months of planting to 450 to 380. Climatic requirement. Climatic conditions for optimum growth of rubber tree. Rainfall of 2000 to 3000 mm evenly distributed without any marked dry season and with 125 to 150 rainy days per annum. Maximum temperature of about 29 degrees to 34 degrees and minimum of about 20 degrees or more with a monthly mean of 25 to 28 degrees. High atmospheric humidity of order of 80%. Bright sunshine amounting to about 2000 hours per annum at the rate of 6 hours per day through all the months. Absence of strong winds. Intercultural operations and weeding. Heavier brassicensis cultivation requires only minimum interculture practices. Weeds compete with rubber for light, moisture and nutrient, particularly during its initial years, and these can be controlled either manually, chemically or mechanically. Rubber is planted at wider spacing. Intercrops such as banana, pineapple, etc. can be grown during initial years. In well-maintained fields, weeding needs to be carried out only in planting strips from 5th year onwards. Diseases and pests. Pests are mealybug, Fericinia virgata, soft-bodied small insect with white mealy outer covering. Occurrence and damage similar to scale insects. Control measures same as for scale insect. Now, termite, white ant, Odontotermus obesus, feeds on dead bark of trees and young plants, builds covered passageways of soil on the tapping panel and collection cup. Sometimes young plants dry up due to attack. Drenching of 0.1% chloropyropus is recommended for control. Now, coccifer grub. It is a white grub. Holotrichus serrata. Feeds on the roots of seedlings in the nursery and young plants. More prevalent near forest areas and in loose soil areas. The affected plants droop and fall off. Drenching soil with 0.03% imidacloprid and 0.075% quinolophos control the grubs. Diseases of rubber. Shoot rot, Phytophthora species. The tender green shoot rot mostly in the nursery seedling and young plants in the field. It was the first observed during southwest monsoon period. Abnormal leaf fall, Phytophthora species. The tender green shoot rot mostly in the nursery growing plants in the field noticed during southwest monsoon period harvesting. The major harvested crop from rubber tree is latex, a colloidal suspension in which 30 to 45% is natural rubber. Latex is harvested by the controlled excision of thin bark strips from main trunk using a specialized knife process known as tapping. During tapping, latex vessels are cut and latex runs through the channel formed by the cut and collected in collection cups. Seed production and yield. Seeds for stock plant nurseries are collected mostly from monoclonal and polyclonal plantations with an aim to produce vigorous hybrid seeds for stock plants. Polyclonal seed gardens have been established in a few locations in India. Due to natural cross-pollination among different chosen clones planted in specific crossing layouts, the seeds produced are expected to possess more hybrid vigor, and hence to stock plants would be healthier with high vigor. Rubber yield steeply increases year by year, reaching a peak after 14 years of planting. In southern India, the annual yield of rubber is 375 kgs per hectare from seedling trees, whereas budded plants yield 800 to 1000 kg per hectare. In multiple choice questions. First one, which tree gives out the latex to obtain natural rubber? The options are A. Eucalyptus, B. Hevea brevilensis, C. Anogenesis, D. Astragalus. The answer is Hevea brevilensis. Second, which component has the maximum composition in Hevea rubber latex? Option A. Rubber hydrocarbon. Option B. Water. Option C. Protein. Option D. Sugar. The answer is water. Third, which substance is added to dilute latex to prevent darkening of the latex? The options are A. Sodium bisulfate, B. Potassium bisulfate, C. Sodium sulfate, D. Potassium sulfate. The answer is sodium bisulfate. Fourth, rubber plantations are located mostly on. Options given are A. Kerala and Karnataka, B. Karnataka and Tamil Nadu, C. West Bengal and Kerala, D. Maharashtra and Kerala. The answer is Kerala and Karnataka. Fifth, which of the following represent natural rubber chemically? Options given are A. Cis-1,4 polyisoprene, B. Trans-1,4 polyisoprene, C. Cis-1,3 polyisoprene, D. Trans-1,3 polyisoprene. The answer is Cis-1,4 polyisoprene. Thank you for your kind attention.